Yes, ma'am.
I am.
This is a video.
We gonna start this thing all right. Duval in the motherfucking house. Come on, come on. Do it, baby, stick it, baby. Do it, baby, stick it, baby. Do it, baby.
I'm living my best life. Ain't going back and forth with you niggas. I'm living my best life. Ain't going back and forth with you niggas. I'm living my best life. Ain't going back and forth with you niggas. I'm living my best life. Ain't going back and forth with you niggas.
What's up, guys? Welcome to my evil lair. Alright, y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead and do it right now. Go ahead and just share this video. Go ahead and share the past ones, like, comment, all of them, you know. Go ahead, you know, just do it. Spam it. Spam me. Alright, y'all. So as you can tell, I'm by myself. I put on my social media that I'm gonna be doing a story time about my thumb. Now you're like, what's wrong with your thumb? You have them, right? No, I have half of a thumb. High four. So I'm going to be getting into what happened, how it happened, how long ago it was, all the questions that all y'all have been asking me and dying to know. Oh, the bathroom lighting makes me look like a shiny lizard. Okay, not any better, but it's okay. My mom doesn't want to do YouTube anymore. I just want to give y'all an update on what's been happening lately. My mom doesn't want to do YouTube anymore. She really doesn't have the time, but it's okay. I wanted this to be a mother and daughter channel. We're going to figure out how we're going to work it out and do all this stuff together. We're going to figure it out. It's another thing. I've been doing pranks, y'all. I've been doing pranks all week. My mom is unprankable. I'm telling you, I did a hickey prank. I done it. I recorded it. I feel like it's not worth recording and posting because it's a fail. I did that. Did the icy hot prank. It ain't work, y'all. But I have some other pranks in mind. Hopefully they work. I don't know when I'ma do it, but I'ma do it for y'all. Even if it's a fail, we're gonna figure it out. I'm gonna figure it out. Anyways. So, without further ado, let's get into the story time. So, this was around, I don't know, like fifth grade, possibly. I was 11 years old. It was 2 days before school started. This occurred at Slitterbond in Galveston. This is a very short story, so... If you think it's gonna be like super long, it's not. It's very short and simple. Nothing too drastic or anything. So I was in the wave pool. Now everyone knows that the wave pool in Slitterbond is also like the lazy river kind of. It's basically a circle around the park, but it's a wave pool. I went with two friends I've never been to Slitterbond, and then I was with my mom. We were going around, a couple of times or whatever, and all of a sudden, like, the wave stopped, you know, like, the wave has to continue to make itself bigger. So, there's a wall there. If you've ever been to Slitterbond, y'all know what I'm talking about. If you don't, just look it up. It's very simple. There's a wall here, and on the other side of that wall is where all the waves are being made and everything. Now, not normal people, but people normally stand beside that wall and jump in front of the wave so that they can get the full power or force when so they can drift off. Excuse me, can't talk today. I want to do the same exact thing, not knowing that there was a vent at the bottom of this wall here. Let's say this is a wall. Of this wall here. I have my hands like this. One. I have my hand like this. And move the other one to see. And my hand got sucked into the vent. And I was just like, you know, kind of like shocked. I was like, what the heck's going on? Like, You know, and like I've told a lot of people this, I'm assuming that like, you know, the suction of it being made on the other side must like suck the air in, you know? So on the other side, my mom's like way ahead of me. She's like 10, 20 feet ahead of me. My friends are in tubes and et cetera. And I'm like, you know, I'm just stuck back here with like a bunch of strangers, stuck. And my mom's like, you know, are you okay? What's up? Like, come on. And I'm like, my thumb's stuck. She's like, your thumb's stuck. I'm like, yeah, bro, my thumb is stuck. It's stuck in a vent. And she goes, pull it out. And I'm like, okay. Like, I'm not thinking anything bad's gonna happen. I'm just, you know, like, okay, this is weird, but we're just gonna pull it out. Pull it out. Blood went everywhere. I yelled, Mom, my thumb is off. My thumb is off. She was like, what? Mom started rushing. She started rushing to me. She put my thumb in the air. Now, anyone who's ever been in Slitterbond knows that the wall in Slitterbond is like 13 feet high. A lifeguard jumped down. He was holding on, or I was holding on to him. My mom was trying to hold on to me. It was just kind of like a very like sad moment. At that time, I was crying. Like a lot. A lot of people asked me that. I cried a lot. It was a lot of blood. I do have a picture, but I know I can't show it because I might get demonetized. So yeah. When they had to like clear out the whole entire like pool area to like evacuate because there was like blood everywhere. I tell you, it was dripping. They put me in a wheelchair, rushed me to the Slitterbond first aid area. And I was kind of nervous and like super confused on why I was going to the first aid area when I lost my thumb. Like, it was kind of like, yo, I need to be going to the hospital. Like, I need to be in an ambulance. Like, let's go. I need to be going to the ambulance. They had me try to sign a whole bunch of papers. Not anyone. I'm right-handed, not left-handed. So when I say they had me writing, I was writing with this hand. They had me write a whole bunch of papers, my name, address, all this other stuff. And then they finally took me to an ambulance. I was sitting there. They probably put like, I think it's called 5 IVs in my arm. And like, I still felt pain and everything. I was like, yo, whatever y'all doing, it's not working. Like, back up. Y'all need to start stitching and giving me a numbing shot or something. Because, still no finger here. In the process of them writing my name down or having me fill out forms at the first aid and then me traveling to the hospital, they were looking for my thumb. Now, by the time we got there, and they had a doctor, like, ready for me to get my finger done, like, to get it either my thumb put back on or to just flip the skin over. So by the time I got there, they were like, oh, we couldn't find it, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, well, this is kind of crazy. Like, I'm just not going to have a thumb. And I was scared. My mom was scared. It was very, very shocking. Two of my friends, like I told you, the first time there, it was a bad experience for them. I know it was. I was actually kind of nervous because I was low-key thinking about them the whole time. I wasn't really thinking about myself. I was just like, you know, I ruined this for them. Like, this is scary. You know, my mom, she's sitting here beside me. She's crying. She's holding my hand. And I'm like, oh, crap. The doctor's standing here on the side of me telling me, you know, what he's going to do, what's going to happen. And I'm sitting here like, I'm going to sit here and watch this man cut off my finger. Now, I leave a lot of details out. When I say cut off my finger, so I still have my knuckle, but they had cut part of it off. So when I say they couldn't find my finger, they couldn't find the meat part. So the vent only took off the meat part of my thumb, and my bone was sticking out. So they had to cut my bone off, pull the skin on the opposite side, and then stitch it to the other. If y'all can see it, that's what it looks like. I just don't have a thumb. After that, they had like a whole bunch of people come over with like tablets and everything to basically distract me from what was going on this side, what he was doing. I was watching, I remember so well, I was watching My Babysitter's a Vampire. That was like my favorite show of all time during the summer. If you like the show, you know, comment down below. That's my show. But they had one lady hold a laptop, I mean a tablet, so that I would be distracted from looking over at my thumb. And then it was super weird in the time being because there was another lady here on the, like, the top of a bed or procedure table, I guess what you say, whatever. And she was like rubbing my eyebrows. It was making me sleepy, and she told me before it even happened. She was like, my mom used to do this to maybe help me go to sleep. I was like, this is weird, but like it's working. I was falling asleep so fast, yeah. The procedure didn't take longer than about an hour. Not even that, I doubt. But we had like 7 people around. I'm not sure if they were trainers. Ooh. Trainees and trainers. I feel like they were trainees and trainers basically just watching what to do when you go into procedure. Someone would lose a thumb or just any kind of procedure at all. And it was like 7 people. After that, it was kind of, I was there for about 30 minutes. After the 30 minutes happened, it was kind of like, I was so quiet. I was dead to the world. I didn't want to talk to nobody. I didn't want to see nobody. I didn't feel like talking to anyone. We went to Chick-fil-A. We got some food. I didn't even eat any of it. I just gave it to a homeless man on the street. I was like, you can have it. Here you go. Went home. When I tell you, the whole street was like lined up with cars. And even in my driveway, like, we couldn't get in our own driveway. Got home, everybody was just looking at me. Sat down in the middle of the couch. Nobody was sitting down. Everybody was just staring at me. It was like awkward silence for about 5 to 10 minutes. I didn't want to deal with anybody. I didn't want to talk to no one. It was very, very depressing and sad. Only because, like, you know, nothing's bad gonna happen. It's gonna be an amazing day, like, we'll come back in one piece and everything. Like, that's your mindset. You know, you try to stay positive. You don't think about, oh my God, like, what if I get my finger cut off? Like, it's crazy because I never thought this would happen to me. And, like, when my mom suggested that I go see therapists, we went to, like, 4 or 5 therapists. And I tell you, I didn't want to talk about it. My mindset was that it happened. It's over with. Start bringing it up. Like, I've lost a thumb. That's it. Like, period, point blank. Let's move on with life. Like, I'm trying to do better. I'm trying to, like, live my life. Like, if something else happens, something else happens. Like, it is what it is. It happened for a reason, right? After that, it was just kind of like, now, like, I just laugh about it at this point. Like, there are some things that I can't do that I wouldn't say aggravates me. It's just kind of weird. Like, I've learned to type with one hand because I feel like normally a lot of people type with 2 hands or text with 2 hands, should I say. I can, like, text really, really fast with one hand. I can't really play video games, which sucks. I make jokes about it. A lot of my friends make jokes about it. We talk about, like, high four or, like, you know, thumbs up, like, it's kind of like, it's always something that I make out of it because it's not really a big deal anymore. Like, it happened so long ago, I don't really think about it as much compared to, like, when it happened back then. It was kind of like, oh my God, like, I feel like I lost a part of myself. I feel like I lost my whole arm, when in reality, it's just, like, a tip of my finger. It's not that bad. It is sad, but I mean, it is what it is. At the end of the day, you know, I'm still living my best life. I'm still here. I'm still smiling. This positivity, all this energy and creativity going on. You know what? Who could be upset? All right, y'all. That's the end of this video. It's story time. Sorry I was jumping from, like, place to place and detail to detail. I'm all over the place. But I do want you to go ahead, like, comment, subscribe, go ahead and share with all your friends, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, comment down below on one of my pictures or under this video and tell me what I should do next. Like, y'all have to give me ideas. I've been, like, a whole month without posting videos, and I'm very, very sorry about that. But I have to give you some ideas. I can't do it by myself. So go ahead and comment, like, and subscribe. And I'm going to do a collab with somebody. Y'all tell me who I should do a collab with and what about. That's what I want to do. Let's do collabs. Let's start that. All right, y'all. Also, comment down below what y'all did for spring break. That's what it was. Comment down below what y'all did for spring break. If it was fun, if it wasn't, you know, give me details. Okay. Live your life to the fullest. Because it is what you make of it. I think that's what I said. Y'all, I'm winding shot. Bye.